Klassikere som E.T., Indiana Jones og Schindlers Liste, den anden forvandlede Ringenes Herre til en af filmhistoriens største succeser. Nu har Steven Spielberg og Peter Jackson slået kræfterne sammen om at lave en film med den evigt unge Tintin. Udvalgte journalister fra hele verden har smugkigget på filmen og mødt de to mesterinstruktører, blandt dem TV2's Ole Kolster. Her er hans beretning.
Første stop er Charles de Gaulle Lufthavnen i Frankrig. Og så videre med bus til Paris. På hotelværelset studerer jeg kortet over storbyen for at finde vores mødested tæt på Champs-Élysées. I kufferten ligger papirer med spørgsmål til Mr. Spielberg og Mr. Jackson.
Tintin is a reporter like me, and if he was sitting in my chair, can you imagine what he would like to ask you about?
Well, he wouldn't be sitting. Number one, he was a roving reporter, and often he was a running reporter, and often he was a ducking reporter, and often he was a fighting reporter. So what he would be saying to us, I think, would be, what are we sitting around for? Let's go have an adventure.
Did you hit anything? You
know, I have this image of Tintin always getting back from an adventure, sitting down, putting the paper in the typewriter, and about to type the story up, and then getting swept away in the next adventure.
Right.
I don't know whether he ever got a lot actually filed with the newspaper.
Wow!
Tintin er tidligere filmatiseret i lavtekniske versioner. Med Spielberg og Jacksons samarbejde rykker den evigt unge spejderdreng op i den moderne digitale tidsalder.
What's this?
Makkerparet bruger virkelige skuespillere, og efter en tur i computeren kommer det hele ud som en animationsfilm, naturligvis i 3D.
Tintin, by the way.
Is he a hero of today?
I would hope so.
I hope he's a hero for today. He doesn't fly. Yeah. You know, bullets don't bounce off of him. He doesn't have superpowers. He's not telekinetic.
He's vulnerable. He slips over. He bangs his head. He's not perfect.
And some of his best friends sometimes frustrate him more than they help him solve these problems and mysteries. But at the same time, his tenacity is unstoppable, and I think people will identify and relate to that.
Tintin kom til verden i 1929. Bøgerne er solgt i 200 millioner eksemplarer.
That's Tintin!
Og nu er denne europæiske kulturskat lagt i hænderne på en amerikaner og en New Zealander.
Never once have there been conversations about updating Tintin to a modern age. Never once have been conversations about Americanizing Tintin. We've never once had a conversation about changing his trousers, even. I mean, it's iconic. It's part of popular culture.
Steven Spielberg og Peter Jackson har slået tre album sammen til én film.
Good boys, no.
Spielberg instruerer, Jackson producerer, og så vil de senere lave endnu en Tintin-film, hvor de bytter roller.
Can you see some part of yourself in the character Tintin?
Oh yes, I can. Of course.
You know. Dogged determination.
Oh yeah.
You know, never wanting to give up. I mean, it's important, and that's a very much a filmmaker trait. I think you can't give up once you start.
I mean, Tintin. Well, you can't say no to Tintin, and Tintin will not take no for an answer. And Tintin cannot be stopped, and he has to get his story. I spent 30 years between the time I read my first Tintin book and sitting here today to get this Tintin movie made.
That's a very Tintin-like.
That's
quality.
A Tintin-like quality. Yeah.
Spielberg og Jacksons Tintin-film kommer i biograferne den 27. oktober. Men på vores hjemmeside, der kan du allerede nu se et klip fra filmen og et interview med skuespilleren Andy Serkis, der spiller Kaptajn Haddock. Det er på nyhederne tv2.dk.